Perhaps you have a child, grandchild, niece or nephew that you would like to introduce to Napoleonic Wargaming. How do you do that? Well, I've got four games suggested for you coming right up. Hello, fellow wargamers and history buffs. Looking to get a gift for a young person and you want to try to introduce them to your favorite hobby, my favorite hobby, here are some suggestions for you. And these are kind of geared for different maybe age ranges, some of them being more simple for maybe younger boys and girls, all the way up to something that might be more appropriate for a teenager. So let's take a look at each of them in order from simplest to more complicated. Hey, just a quick note, all of the items I'm showing you were purchased, and I'm not getting any compensation from the makers of these games. The first one up is Travel Battle from Perry Miniatures. And I think this would be ideal for a boy or girl, maybe 8 years old up to maybe 10, 12 years old. The nice thing about it is that everything is all in one box that doubles as a carrying case. It's going to have your battle board. It has the little pieces, and so it has sort of a toy soldier feel to it, which I know is appealing a lot to kids that are used to playing with small toys. So this should be something that would be worth taking a look at. Now, the game itself comes with two battle boards. The battle boards have, these embossed features on them, including the squares that the units move around in. It's got little farms here. It's got a set of woods with a top that comes off, so you can put your units in the woods, I guess. And then with the roads, everything connects, so then you can have your pieces here. It comes with numerous, blue and red units, including infantry, cavalry, artillery, and leaders. So if you're looking for something that's going to be nice, a little project, you can, go ahead and glue these on. If you want to paint them, you can do that too. If you want to paint the farmlands, if you want to paint the trees, things like that, this can make a nice little project for you and the young person that you are giving this to or sharing it with. It's got a very short little rule book, which basically talks about the basics, sequence of play, the units, how to assemble everything, and then, of course, the rules all together. It's, maybe 6-7 pages, not very much at all. And then, of course, it's got information about, how you can put it together. You can get multiple sets and make a larger battle if you want to. But very, very simple, very easy to play. This is a good option for a young person who wants to have sort of the feel of model soldiers, little miniatures. But then the whole thing fits in a nice little case, easy to travel and set up and play. The next game up is Enemy in Sight. This was originally published by Avalon Hill back in the 1980s, and it has been republished by Lost Battalion Games. They've done a really nice job improving the production quality, so the cards are very nice and all the pieces are very nice. This is a fun multiplayer game and pretty easy for people to learn and to play. The game comes with a rule book, a pair of dice, a set of markers, and then there are two card decks. One is the ships, and then the other is going to be the action cards. Now, there are probably 50 sets of ship cards here. that represent ships from the Napoleonic era, and they are coming from the French fleet, the British fleet, the American fleet, and the Spanish fleet. And they have different ships of different quality, first-rate ships like the Orient and the Victory, and then lesser ships like the Argonauta and the United States. And so there's a whole bunch of them that are in there. And so this is what you're making up your fleet with, these ship cards. In the action card deck, there are plentiful and numerous ammunition cards. These are the ones that you're using to shoot at your opponent's fleet to damage their rigging or to damage their hull. You can then do boarding parties. You can retreat from the battle. You can blockade somebody else's port. There's the opportunity to set fire to an opposing ship. Bow rakes, stern rakes, all kinds of fun actions that are going on with this fast-paced game. You can have about six players play this. Everyone's going to have their own fleet. And the game itself, you can finish it up here in about an hour or so, depending on how, you know, what point limit you set for a victory. Now, the rule book itself is about 23 pages long. It's got all the information you need here. It's a color rule book. Talks about the different types of cards, has information about all the particular cards and how they work. It includes an example of play, and it's well written, and so it definitely makes it easy to kind of pick up the game and start to play it. Command and Colors is another good choice. For kids particularly, and for a sort of a lighter war game, it has a nice tactile feel. You can get a sense of what a Napoleonic battle kind of looks like. It's got a number of scenarios and things like that available. And the game itself is card-driven. So you're going to be, you know, drawing cards each player, each turn, and then deciding whether you're going to be making the attack on the left, the right, the center, or whatever happens to work for them based on the cards that they are dealt. Game itself tends to play pretty quickly and is easy to do. But for a lot of people, you know, you're going to have a little project putting all the stickers on everything. But other than that, it's pretty much ready to go once you've got that done. Another nice feature is with the combat system, you don't need to calculate odds. You're just going to be throwing the dice, and based on the results of the dice, it's going to indicate if there's a hit or units have to retreat or what the case might be. So this makes it easy for folks that are getting started into the wargaming. Not a lot of mathematics involved. There are great player aids for you. One here with the terrain effects chart, and then inside it's got information about the different cards that are in the deck. And then you're going to have a player aid here for ranged fire and the melee tables, and then it's got information about the various and sundry units. Now, if you are looking for a game for maybe a teenager, then this would be one I would recommend. This is Albuera 1811 from White Dog Games. It is a brigade scale game, so the different pieces for the French and the British and their allies represent a brigade. And the map itself has got spaces, so it's sort of area movement, so it's not hex and counter. But the game itself and the rules really do a great job of sort of capturing the Napoleonic rock, paper, scissors kind of, you know, integration of combat units. It's a challenging battle for both players, and it's an easy enough one that I've had 10-year-olds in my summer school class pick this one up and play it with a fair amount of confidence. So this would be another one to get. You can either purchase the game already printed, or you can purchase a digital version of the game and then download it and then take it to your local, office supply store, or if you've got a decent printer, you can print out the components at home. The game includes the standard rules for this particular battle, and I think that they were talking about maybe coming out with a few other battles using the same system. I haven't seen anything yet, but I'd certainly welcome it. So it's got the rules. They have got some options, but altogether, you're looking at about, say, 15, 16 pages of rules. Pretty easy to learn and work with, full color, with a description of what's going on there. There are reference cards for the players so that they have a handy reference regarding movement, combat, etc. And then there is a rule book here with the scenarios. Also has examples of combat, examples of play, and different sort of variations that you can do. So if you're looking to mix this up after you've played this a few times, there's different options for you, so that way it doesn't get stale. Well, I hope that you enjoyed a look at these games that I think are a good introduction to the hobby. If you have suggestions for games that you think would be good, go ahead and make those in the comments section below. And I will have links to the publishers for the games I mentioned down in the show notes. As always, if you like the video, go ahead and click the like button. And if you're interested in hearing more about how I use these games and some others in a summer camp program I did, you can take a look at the video coming up over here or over here. Until then, keep gaming, have fun, and be well. If you have suggestions of your own for games that you think would be good to get someone started in the hobby, go ahead and make those in the comment section below. Story of my life.